My name is Mark Baratz. I'm a hand and upper extremity surgeon. I trained in medical school at the University of Pittsburgh. I finished that in 1984. I did my residency at the University of Pittsburgh and then a fellowship in hand and upper extremity surgery at Allegheny General. I've been in practice since, taking care of hand and arm problems, and today we're going to talk about Dupuytrens contracture. Dupuytrens contracture is a condition that involves the skin and the tissue just beneath the skin. It is a condition where the cells that normally sit pretty quietly in our skin become hyperactivated, and they produce extra materials, things like collagen and other what we call substrates of tissue, to an extent that they actually produce a contracture in your hand and cause the fingers to draw toward the palm. As your fingers draw in toward the palm, they get in the way. So one of the most difficult things is putting your hand in a glove. So if your fingers are drawn up, that's a challenge. If you have a pair of pants, like a pair of jeans that are a little bit tight, getting your hand into a pocket is a problem. Shaking hands is awkward. It's sort of socially uncomfortable when your fingers are pulled in. And then it can get in the way if you use your hands for work or for play, music, art, any of those other things. So people can confuse arthritis with Dupuytrens contracture in the early stages, because in arthritis you have a hard time moving your fingers, and in Dupuytrens contracture you have a hard time straightening your fingers. We will get people at all different stages of Dupuytrens contracture, and often we'll get them in the very early stages of Dupuytrens contracture when they're most worried about how their skin looks and feels. And the truth is that Dupuytrens involves the skin, and it will always be within the skin no matter what we do. But if it's only involving the skin and it's only causing a little bump in the palm, we don't do anything about it. We wait and watch. We really don't intervene. We don't do early intervention in Dupuytrens contracture until the fingers are starting to draw in and interfere with hand function. The treatment for Dupuytrens contracture depends on the stage that a person has the disease. So in the very early stages where it only involves the skin, we wait and watch. There are rare instances where people will have what's called a nodule. It's just a bump in the palm, and that bump bothers them when they're resting their hand on a steering wheel or when they're gripping something firmly. And in those instances, sometimes we'll inject that nodule with a little bit of steroid. But most of the times, we're not going to offer an intervention or a treatment until their fingers start to pull in and get in the way. Typically, it's when your big knuckle pulls in about 30 degrees and when there's any significant contracture in the second knuckle, the one that's between the big knuckle and the end knuckle. So it's this one here called the PIP joint. So people want and need to know what their options are with Dupuytrens contracture. And the thing that we try to do is we try to tailor that treatment to their stage in life, how much it interferes with what they do, whether it's interfering with work or whether it's interfering with recreation. And there's three different kinds of treatment. The first treatment is something that's called percutaneous needle aponeurotomy. And what's nice about percutaneous needle aponeurotomy is it's a very minimally invasive technique. It's something that I could do for you in the office the first or second time that I saw you. So I simply numb the skin, and once the skin is numb, I can use a very fine needle to release what is called a cord. So a cord is a band of tissue just beneath your skin that extends from your palm out to your finger. And because your hand is numb, you won't feel it, but you will feel a pop and suddenly your finger is straight. A second technique that I can use is something called enzymatic digestion, or collagenase, that we use to break up the cords. And this is something that we inject into the hand and then we wait and watch. We give you 24 to 48 hours to let that enzyme work. Once that enzyme has worked, I can bring you back into the office. I can numb your hand and then do that same manipulation. And most of the time with that one injection and that one to two day period of time, I'll be able to straighten your finger out. The third form of treatment is an operation. And we use an operation in those instances where there's very significant involvement of both the hand and the finger, where we don't think those needle treatments are going to be sufficient. And it is more involved, but the advantage of it is that this is a condition that never goes away. Is this contracture going to come back? And to some extent, it always comes back a little bit. The question is, will it come back enough that you need more treatment? And that has to do a little bit with the treatment and a lot with how your cells work. I think the two things that are most satisfying to me are being able to solve a problem, or at least work toward a solution, and I love to teach. So we're at a teaching institution and we have trainees, and that is something that I look forward to every day, working with them.